Can you develop autism as an adult? Nope, it is how your brain formed and developed in the womb.
That's such a funny word.
But yeah, autism is something you're born with.
This is also why vaccines causing autism makes no sense, because vaccines don't change the entire structure of your brain.
But this doesn't mean you can't be diagnosed autistic as an adult.
It's missed for a lot of reasons.
For example, I wasn't diagnosed until a few years ago. One of my parents was also undiagnosed autistic, so they were like, this behavior is normal.
It was not normal.
Plus, it can be harder for females to get diagnosed and other marginalized groups and people of color, and it's a whole problem.
You're born with it.
Yeah.
How does that even make... You just stabbed me? What is your problem?
One thing that is more difficult about living more on my own is the social interactions. Before, someone would be in a completely different room doing their own thing. I mean, sometimes I could see them, and I would be doing my own thing, and I'm like, great, I am fulfilling my need for people. Now, it's when people check up on me, or it's, I am coming over to your house, or they are coming over to my apartment. It's like, sometimes I just want a person in a different room that I can't see. But knowing that they're there, and that fulfills my need for human interaction.
I don't know, it's weird. I mean, I want human interaction. I love getting together with my friends. I mean, I did that before, but I also want more human interaction than I'm getting, but I want that human interaction to be different than what is socially expected.
It's not exactly socially acceptable to invite someone over and just put them in a room.
Okay, so I really struggled in school. High school was rough. So when I graduated, I was like, college? I have to do this all over again? And with my other disabilities, college wasn't really realistic for me to do. So I was like, well, I like art, so I want to apprentice. So I found an artist I really liked. I'm like, I want to learn how to paint like he paints. And I asked, hey, are you taking students? And he said, no. But then I just kept showing up to other events where he would be painting, and I heard he hated cleaning his brushes. So then I called him and I said, hey, I will clean your brushes if you can just let me sit and watch you paint. And then I convinced him to teach me, and then he ended up getting more students and making a whole apprenticeship program, and it was fabulous. Yeah, so I ended up doing that for 5 years. It was fantastic. I loved it so much. It was the greatest thing ever.
Nice.
I love sticking to a schedule, and it is very important for me. It makes the world make a little more sense than it does. I feel like I'm constantly on guard, like, what is going to happen next? Who knows? And it is very stressful. So having a schedule kind of gets rid of some of that. It's not necessarily having a schedule for I do this at this time, but I do things in a certain order, and I do have a few things that I do at a certain time. It used to be laundry. So yeah, when I end up staying up all night doing my special interest, it does mess things up. I tend to be more overstimulated when I don't stick to my schedule because I'm having to process a lot more information because I don't know what is going on. I already struggle with overstimulation with all the lights and noises my brain has to process, so why do I want to give my brain more to process? Having my routine means less overstimulation, which means less meltdowns and shutdowns. Life. So when I was little, my mom put me in ballet classes. I absolutely loved it. I loved all the movement. My favorite part was spinning in circles. But even though I loved it, every time before class, I would have a lot of meltdowns and tears, and it was bad. And it was all for one reason: the sensory issues with tights. The tights when I was younger were so thick and itchy, and they were horrible. So yeah, I did eventually quit ballet, only because of the tights. But I was a bluebird in a Cinderella play. It was great. I mean, I kind of did my own thing, was just spinning in a circle while the class did their dance. Yep.
Okay, let's talk about what we just saw. I, for one, did not care for it.
That's a great question. Let me think how I want to answer this.
It's yes or no.
I made a very bad choice. I decided to engage in my special interest at 10 o'clock at night. that is when I'm supposed to go to bed. Am I in bed? No.
I'm sorry, that looks so funny.
So for a while now, I've slowly been building a collection of tanks. A few of them are from you guys, thank you so much. But I've been watching a lot of Peter's videos from Bugs in Cyberspace, and I'm so close to having all the materials for a whole bunch of insects.
I've been watching so many videos on domino roaches.
I mean, look how amazing these are. They're so cute.
Have I tried to go to sleep? Yeah, but my brain won't be quiet.
So I've decided just to give in, and now it's so late, but I'm running on pure special interest adrenaline.
I know I'm gonna regret this. Camera angles make funny faces.
I mean, I'm making the faces, but the camera angle makes it funnier. People ask, what is the best way to learn about autism? From autistic people. And there are so many amazing autistic creators out there. So here are some small autistic creators that I quite enjoy. I recently discovered NeuroDominoes. They are fantastic. They share a lot of their personal experiences, which I love. Another autistic Cassie. They are fantastic at doing their research. Kyle is super awesome and also shares personal experiences of what it's like to be an autistic adult. I recently found Artisan and they make jewelry. I really want to get some of their jewelry because it is fantastic for oral stimming. Black Autistic Keen is great. He also sings and his special interest is Marvel. Autistic Alex is fantastic. I love his videos. They're so funny and I love hearing his different perspective. Okay, I absolutely love that they're just sitting in their car being like, I experienced this today. And I'm just like, yes, relatable. Trevor is awesome and also shares about his special interest of Pokemon. Retrophiliac also has some awesome autistic products. There's so many and I'm running out of time. You
love her. Oh. He knows the song too.
How do you show her you love her?
Know what I find really difficult? Trying to end a conversation. I really struggled with this when I was younger. Once in kindergarten, I was having a conversation with a girl and I just told her, I am tired of talking and walked away. I was tired of talking. I was becoming overstimulated. I was so confused why she didn't like me after that. Over time, I did learn that you can't end conversations like that because people think that is very rude. But I still had no idea how to end a conversation. Later in third grade, this girl called me on the phone and I did not know how to end the conversation. I desperately just wanted to draw. But no, we ended up being on the phone for 3 hours because I couldn't get off of it. The only reason that conversation ended was my mom needed the phone and I was just like, thank goodness. And then sometimes I just sit during the conversation trying to figure out how to politely end the conversation and then I realize I have no idea what they just said. It's a real problem when they asked a question.
I think there's days where I feel like I know it all and then I wake up the next morning and I'm like, wait, none of that makes sense.
Okay, this is making me laugh because my first thought when I read this comment was the bed all of a sudden growing arms to try to catch, but then I had to go on being like, oh, to have the strength to catch you, it must have like a support system, so either muscles, but that just seems weird, so maybe a wire system, but then does it have to have like sentient thought? I mean, technically no, but that's where I'm going.
My brain's so entertaining! I can't stop laughing!
Oh, this is cute! I love this kind of stuff. Look at holes.
I'm pretty tired, but today is Autism Awareness / Acceptance Day. So a big part of what this month has meant to me is gaining awareness of what my needs are as an autistic person and learning to accept them. I'm always going to experience meltdowns and shutdowns and need support in my life, but I also can experience that autistic joy, which is a wonderful and beautiful thing.
This is either going to be incredible or it's going to be awful, but either way, it will be.
One thing I've experienced is my behavior changing after I received my diagnosis. A lot of people think that if the behavior changes after the diagnosis, that must mean you are faking it. That's not what is happening.
When I received a diagnosis all of a sudden, I had more information about how my brain works. I was like, oh, that need to flap my hands and make repetitive movements and sounds is a big way on how I process emotions and my sensory surroundings? Maybe I shouldn't force myself to be completely still and be in constant pain and confusion. Surprisingly, letting myself stim solved a lot of mental problems. What is sad is that because of this change of behavior, sometimes you can receive a lot of bullying. I'm currently seeing my friend Bug go through this. Also, some people saying that they're trying to be me because they also like insects and like opening packages. A lot of people like those things. They're fantastic. So know that these changes of behavior are actually very common in late diagnosed autistic people. For me, those behaviors were there. I was just desperately trying to hide them.
Vibe check!
So growing up, sometimes I would do something and my teachers or other people would think I was being rude or passive aggressive, and I was just like, what? For example, once I was asked to do the dishes, and I'm like, great, I'm going to follow instructions. I'm going to do the dishes. I might have overthought this one way too much because did I do the silverware? No. I was like, okay, dishes are like bowls and plates. So I did the bowls and plates and nothing else. And then I said I was done and people were confused. They're like, why did you lie about that? I'm like, what? I didn't lie about that. I did the dishes. I did all of the dishes. I mean, technically, sure. This is why it's so nice to know I'm autistic, because one, they don't get as frustrated and we can laugh about it, explain, I can grow, and it's fantastic. Also, I'm a lot less confused.
You agreed to stay away!
I lied.
So yes, I have seen the show Atypical. So a lot of people ask me if the show is good representation. So here's why it's a little bit of a tricky question for me. So I do relate a lot to the character Sam. The experiences that they showed him having in the show, I experienced a lot of those same things. I would have preferred an autistic actor to play the main character. And this isn't because the actor necessarily did a bad job portraying autism. It is because if you're trying to make a show to educate people on the autistic experience, I want to hear from someone who is autistic. Otherwise, no matter what you do, the show is going to be about the autistic experience from the perspective of someone who isn't autistic. So it isn't my favorite show for autistic representation. A lot of you actually asked me to watch She-Ra when I first started this account, and Intrepta has become one of my favorite autistic characters. And they didn't make a big deal about it. She just was autistic. I love it.
No, but it's not funny. At the end of the day, is it? It's serious.
Here is an example of why the terms high and low functioning can be harmful. I've had doctor appointments where I was not overstimulated, was able to communicate for myself, so I let them know that, hey, I'm autistic, could I have this support? And they said, well, you're obviously high functioning, so no. I had to sit there and explain repeatedly, no, I do need help, this would be super helpful for me, I need this support. But I've also been in the hospital when I've been very overstimulated, needing a lot of support, not able to verbally communicate, thrashing around because I'm in the middle of a meltdown. It was not great. When people saw me in that context, they're like, oh, she is extremely low functioning and cannot make any decisions for herself. I had social services call after that because they were concerned I could not make any decisions for myself. So on one hand, I wasn't getting any support, and on the other, I was having my rights taken away. I do need less support than others, but I still need support.
Butterfly in the sky, I can go twice as high. Take a look, it's in a book, a reading rainbow.
Ever since I was little, I've had a really hard time making friends and keeping relationships. But I was really upset when I discovered that relationships change over time and no one told me. So me and my brother are really, really close, but growing up, obviously, we became adults. All of a sudden, we both had responsibilities, and I couldn't just go exploring and hiking and looking for insects within 24/7. We were entering a new stage of life, which meant the relationship had to shift. I was so upset, why didn't anyone tell me? This is change, and I hate change. Like, what? And then, because I really struggle reading social cues, I don't know how to interpret it. Is this really due to change and that we're in a new stage of life? Or did I do something or miss a social cue and offend someone? I don't know. And then I have to go rewrite all my social scripts because the relationship and dynamic is completely different. Friendships are really complicated.